Hi guys, Francesca here with another home practice. Today we'll be focusing on some hips and hamstrings. So if you have a block, ideally probably two is best, grab those blocks. Again, if you don't have blocks at home, you're always welcome to use anything that's gonna help you get closer to the earth. So books, a bolster, blankets, towels, pillows, anything like that. And just take it at the top of your mat. You may or may not want a strap. Only for a few parts of class, but if you don't have a strap, again, a towel, a belt even, anything like that that can make your arms a little longer is going to be super helpful here. So we'll get started today in Supta Baddha Konasana. Come to your back, bring the soles of your feet together and your knees out wide. When you're on your back, you can place one hand on your heart and one hand on your belly. You're also welcome to relax your arms down by your sides. And start to set your intention for your practice, but start that with the breath. Full breath in. Audible exhale, send it out. Two more times just like that, breathe in. Audible exhale, send it out. One more time, big breath in. Audible exhale, send it out. Seal your lips, breathe in. Sealed lip, breathe out. Now from this space, feel the heat start to happen from your throat, from the center of your chest, from your lungs, and spread throughout your body. From this place of breath, from this place of warmth, start to set your intention for your practice. We have an ability to make a choice on how we show up and how we interact with the world around us. There's a saying that I really love, and it says something like, you don't see a person or a thing or a situation as they are, you see it as you are. So we have this incredible power to shift our understanding and shift our views and shift our interactions by how we show up. So throughout this practice, work on adjusting that. Work on being a not knower. Work on the ability to transform the way you interact with breath, with body, with movement. Take another full breath in, full breath out. From this space, close your knees like books and hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a nice big squeeze. Extend your left leg long, shift into a half happy baby. Grab the inside or the outside of your right foot. Stack your right ankle on top of your right knee and plug your right shoulder blade down to draw your knee towards the earth. If you can't quite reach your foot, grab hold of your knee or ankle or your calf. You can stay right here if it feels good in your body. You can work to straighten your right leg a little bit. We'll continue to work on this action throughout class, but the more you would like to straighten your leg, the more you need to flex your right thigh. So tone your right thigh, drive through your heel to lengthen the back of your leg. Breathe in. Breathe out. Slowly re-bend your knee. Place the sole of your left foot on the mat and cross your right ankle on top of your left thigh for a supine figure four or thread the needle. Pull your left thigh into your chest. Grab hold of your left leg either with your shin bone or with your hand behind your left leg and pull your torso towards the earth, the back of your torso towards the earth. Pull your left thigh bone towards your chest. Flex your right thigh. You can use your right hand to press your right thigh bone away from you. Hold, breathe in. Hold, breathe out. Then slowly extend your right leg long this time. Pull your left thigh bone into your chest and work into your half happy baby. Grab the inside or the outside of your left foot. Stack your ankle on top of your knee. Plug your left shoulder blade down and flex your left foot. Dig your right heel down into the ground. Soften your gaze and grit your jaw and brace your belly just a little bit. That'll help you pull your low back down to the ground. And again, you can keep your left knee bent, or if you'd like to straighten it, you can. If you decide to straighten it and need more intensity, flex your left thigh, drive through your heel. Take a big breath in. Breath out. Slowly draw yourself back in. Place the sole of your right foot on the earth. Stack your left ankle on top of your right thigh and pull your right thigh to your chest for a supine figure four. Again, you can grab hold of the back of your right leg, your hamstring, or you can grab hold of your shin bone. Pull your right thigh bone to you, plug your shoulder blades down, and you can press your left thigh bone away from you using your left hand or your left elbow. Slightly tuck your chin to your chest to lengthen your cervical spine, your neck. Slightly activate through your core again to seal your low back down. And slowly extend both legs forward, point your toes, reach your arms up, big breath in. Exhale, hug your knees to your chest, rock forward and back, until you land onto your hands and knees for a tabletop. Stack your shoulders on top of your wrists, hips on top of your knees. Spread your fingers wide. Pull your rib cage in. You can have your toes tucked or untucked. Now, lean back just a little bit. Breathe in. Exhale, take a big step, right foot forward for a dragon lunge. Now, your stance is a little short, so you can lengthen it here by stepping your left foot back a little bit. Stack your right knee on top of your right ankle. Inhale. Cow pose, pull your heart forward, gaze forward. Exhale, cat, press through your palms, tuck your chin to your chest, and you can press your hips back as much or as little as you like. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Exhale, send yourself back. Cow and cat. Go at your own pace. Just for four. Jerry's doing it too. Three. Two. And one. Step your right foot back, left leg forward, dragon lunge. Again, you're going to be in a little shorter of a stance, so you can lengthen your stance here. Step your shoulders on top of your wrists. Inhale, cow pose, slide your heart forward. Exhale, cat. Again, do sort of any variation of the cat-cow here. You can be really stable in your low body, or you can have a lot of movement. Over-exaggerate. Don't feel connected to any certain shape or form. Just allow breath to control the movement. For four. Three. Two. And one. Slowly land back into your tabletop. Spread your fingers wide. Tuck your toes. Breathe in. Exhale, downward facing dog. Send your hips up and back. Spread your fingers wide. Drive your heels down into the earth. Hug your inner arm bones together. And know that down dog is not about having your heels on the ground. So bend your knees as much as you need to create a long spine. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, come to the top of your mat, ragdoll. Bring your feet hip-width distance or wider. Tuck your hands into your elbow creases and hang your head heavy. Shake your head, yes or no. You can sway side to side. And just a reminder, if there's any part of this practice that you want to pause the video and flow a section a few times or take it really slow, you're welcome to do that. I'm just here to be your guide, but you're welcome to go at your own pace. Relax your hands to the earth. Slowly roll up all the way to standing. Crown of your head is the last to reach the top. Big shoulder roll at the top. Step your feet together. Tadasana arms by your sides. Place your hands at your heart center. Gaze down at your fingertips. Close your eyes if you're comfortable. Take a big breath in. Audible exhale. Send it out. Seal your lips. Breathe in. Sealed lip. Breathe out. Take a moment here to set your intention one more time. Are you able to give yourself the space, the time to reorient, to reattach or to unattach to your expectations, to your future, to your past? In this moment and in this flow, can you give yourself the idea of a new start or a fresh start? Or maybe not a start at all. Can you understand that just because you think something isn't how it should have been or should be, doesn't make it wrong. It's just different. So can you embody that in your flow today? Can you explore that? Full breath in, full breath out. Release your arms down by your side. Inhale, extend in mountain pose. Reach your arms to the sky, Urdhva Hastasana. Wrap your pinky bones in and pull your armpits down. Press through your heels, tone your glutes, and brace your belly. Breathe in. Exhale, swan dive forward, forward fold. Inhale, lift halfway, hover your fingertips. Exhale, high plank, plant your palms and step your feet back. Step your shoulders directly on top of your wrists. Slide your weight forward for chaturanga. Bend your elbows towards 90 degrees. Flip to the tops of your feet. Inhale, upward facing dog. Only 4 points of contact are your hands and your feet. Exhale, downward facing dog. Send your hips up and back. Know that you always can do your chaturanga on your knees. You can always replace your up dog with a cobra pose. You always can skip it altogether and just step back into a down dog. We'll do that in flow. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop or step, top of your mat, feet touch. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, chaturanga, plant your hands, hop or step back. Shift forward and lower down into your elbows. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop or step, top of your mat, feet touch. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, lift halfway, hover your fingertips. Exhale, chaturanga, plant your hands, shift forward and lower down. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog, send your hips up and back. Breathe in and out. You're welcome to flow that two more times on your own. You can pause the video if that's what you like to do. Otherwise, we'll continue to move forward. Inhale, sweep your right leg high. Exhale, draw your knee to your nose. Inhale, high. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, high. Exhale, knee to nose and pause. Breathe in. Exhale, low lunge. Shut your foot between your hands. Lower your back knee down. Inhale, Anjaneyasana, crescent moon. Pull your right hip back and your left hip forward. Tone your left glute. You can have your left toes tucked or untucked. Work your thumb bones back. Breathe in. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. Send your hips back as you flex your right foot. Stack your left hip more or less on top of your left knee. Dig your right heel down and flex your right toes. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Exhale, hinge at your hips and fold. The more you dig your heel down, the more you flex your right thigh, the more intensity you'll feel in your stretch. Create inhales, space. Create exhales and deepen. Inhale, crescent moon, plant your right toes, tuck your left. Inhale, reach your arms to the sky. Exhale, runner's lunge, lift your back knee, sweep your arms back behind you. Pull your shoulder blades together, plug your hip back, tone your left butt cheek. Brace your belly off of your front thigh. Inhale, crescent lunge, tuck your shoulders on top of your hips and sweep your arms to the sky. Similarly to the previous posture, stack your right knee on top of your right ankle, left heel to your left toes, and tone your left thigh. Inhale, exhale, warrior two. Stack your shoulders on top of your hips, stack your right knee on top of your right ankle, and extend your arms forward and back. Plug your shoulder blades together and your armpits down, gaze over your front hands. Inhale, inhale, reverse triangle. Straighten your right leg, bump your hips forward, and sweep your right arm to the sky. You should feel a slight stretch on the inline of your left leg as you reach up and back and press your hips forward. Inhale. Exhale, triangle pose, bump your hips back, tilt your torso forward, take your right arm to the inside of your right leg, and lift your left arm to the sky. You're welcome to rest your hand directly on top of your shin bone as well, or on a block. Continue to wrap your chest open, left arm to the sky. You can progress your gaze from the earth to the side of the space, all the way up to the sky. Press toe to heel in your front foot, heel to toe in your back. Inhale, reverse warrior, bend your right knee. Sweep your right arm up and back. Get low in your legs, reach your torso up and back, and reach to the rib balls of your rib cage and find space there. Breathe in. Exhale, chaturanga, windmill your hands to the mat. If you have an ekapada chaturanga, a three-legged chaturanga, in your practice, you can do that. And by three-legged, I mean one-legged because you only have two legs. Switching sides, inhale, sweep your left leg high. Exhale, draw your knee to your nose. Inhale, take it high. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, take it high. Exhale, knee to nose. Hold it here, breathe in. Exhale, low lunge, step your foot between your hands. Inhale, crescent moon, Anjaneyasana, lower down to your back knee, and sweep your arms to the sky. Slide your pelvis forward and down. You can have your right toes tucked or untucked. Pull your left hip crease back and reach your arms to the sky. Work your thumb bones back and wrap your pinky bones in. Brace your belly. Inhale. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. Plant your hands. Shift your weight back towards your right knee. Keep your right knee stacked on top of your right ankle. This is going to be the safest for your knee. Flex your left foot. Pull your heart forward and fold forward. Pull your left hip crease back. Tug your heart forward and down. Inhales, create space. Exhales, you deepen. And again, the more you flex your left quad, the more your left hamstring has to release. Slowly bend your left knee. Crescent moon, tuck your right toes. Reach your arms up, thumb bones back. Exhale, runner's lunge. Lift your back knee, sweep your arms back. Brace your belly off the waistline of your pants. Pull your left hip back, right hip forward. Tone through your front left thigh. Lift through your right thigh. Inhale, crescent lunge, arms to the sky. Make adjustments in your feet. My stance feels a little short, so I'm going to lengthen it. Stack your right heel on top of your right toes. Tone through your inner thighs. Everything in your low body is toned up and strong. Reach your arms up, brace your belly. Inhale. Exhale, warrior two, open yourself up. Stack your shoulders on top of your hips. Left knee on top of your left ankle. Extend your arms forward and back and gaze over your front hand. Pull your shoulder blades together and your armpits down. Inhale, reverse triangle. Straighten your front leg, bump your hips forward, and reach your left arm to the sky. Press your right inner thigh forward and feel for that stretch. Breathe in. Exhale, triangle pose, bump your hips back. Take your left arm to the inside of your left leg and sweep your right arm to the sky. Remember, you can rest your hand on your shin bone or have a block underneath your hand as well. Wrap your left rib cage underneath you. Extend your fingertips to the sky. Press toe to heel in your front foot, heel to toe in your back, and brace your belly. Inhale, reverse warrior. Bend your front knee. Sweep your left arm up. Focus on creating space in both sides of your rib cage. Drive down through your legs as you lift up through your torso. Breathe in. Exhale, chaturanga. Windmill your hands down to the ground. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a breath in and out, and we'll do this breath to movement. I'll do the first one with you. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, just knee to nose and hold it. Breathe in. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent moon, back knee down. Sweep your arms to the sky. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. Inhale, crescent moon, tuck your left toes. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, triangle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, chaturanga. Again, option for that one-legged chaturanga. Up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Send your left leg high. Breathe in. Exhale, exhale, draw your knee to your nose, hold it here. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent moon, back knee down, arms up. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits. Inhale, crescent moon. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, triangle. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, chaturanga or ekapada chaturanga. Remember, you always can skip it, high plank, to down dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. We've got one more. I'll just cue you. You focus on your breath. Don't worry if you mess up a little bit. Just stay committed and connected to movement. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, draw your knee to your nose. Hold it here. Breathe in. Exhale, step your foot between your hands. Low lunge. Inhale, crescent moon. Back knee down. Sweep your arms to the sky. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman. Straighten your front leg and fold. Inhale, crescent moon. Tuck your back toes. Arms up. Exhale, runner's lunge. Lift your back knee. Chest forward. Arms back. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Straighten your front leg. Exhale, triangle pose, bump your hips back. Inhale, reverse warrior, bend your right knee, sweep up and back. Exhale, chaturanga, windmill your hands down to the earth. Inhale, up dog or cobra, meeting places, downward facing dog. Inhale, send your left leg high, you've got this, stick with it. Exhale, knee to nose and hold it here, breathe in. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent moon, back knee down, sweep your arms up, brace your belly. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits, hinge at your hips and fold. Inhale, crescent moon, tuck your back toes, arms up. Exhale, runner's lunge, lift your back knee, chest forward. Inhale, crescent lunge, brace your belly, squeeze your inner thighs. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle, bump your hips forward. Exhale, triangle, bump your hips back. Inhale, reverse warrior, bend through your front knee. Exhale, chaturanga, windmill your hands down. Upward facing dog, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Really good. We're gonna do that one more time with a few additions. Take a breath in and a breath out. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, draw your knee into your nose, inhale. Exhale, low lunge, back knee down. Inhale, crescent moon, arms up. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman, half splits and fold. Now, hold it here, we've done the center line. Take your hands to the inside of your right foot and walk your feet towards, rock your hands to the top left corner of your mat. Pull your right hip back, dig through your right heel and flex your right toes. Pull your heart forward and down. You have three muscles that make up your hamstring muscle, so three little pieces that make up the big piece. This multitude of stretching in Ardha Hanuman will get all three of those pieces. Slowly come back to center, walk your hands to the pinky edge of your right foot, hinge at your hips, and fold. This is usually the more challenging side, so if only one hand gets over, that's okay. You can always put blocks underneath your hands. Slowly come back to center. Bend your right knee and toe heel your right foot out for a runner's lunge variation. Parallel your left shin bone to the back of your mat. Keep your right knee stacked on top of your right ankle. Take your hands toward the top left corner of your space and send your hips back and down. This is one of my favorite hip stretches. The more you tone and squeeze your right butt cheek, the more intensity you'll feel. The further you sit your hips back, the more intensity you'll feel. Slowly come back to center. Turn your left toes back. Now, if you have that strap or your towel nearby, use it here. Left hand on the earth or on your block. Inhale, send your right arm high. Exhale, quad stretch, King Arthur stretch. Reach back with your right hand and grab the pinky edge of your left foot. Tone through your left butt cheek, spiral your chest open, brace your belly. Slowly release. Toe heel your right foot back to center. Set yourself up in your arch crescent moon. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, triangle. Pause here. Inhale, sweep your top arm forward. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold. Parallel your feet, hinge at your hips, and fold. Start with your hands beneath your shoulders, then as you straighten your legs and lengthen your spine, then start to walk your hands between your legs. You can even grab your hands towards your big toes or hands to your outer heels. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Press your kneecaps back. Inhale, slowly lift up halfway. Exhale, crawl forward, chaturanga. Inhale, send your left heel high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, crescent moon. Sweep your arms high. Exhale, Ardha Hanuman. Straighten your left leg. Take your hands to the inside, the big toe edge side of your left foot towards the top right corner of your space. Plug your left hip back, right hip forward, and fold. Again, dig your heel down. Flex through your thigh. Fold forward and down. You're getting all three pieces of the hamstring muscle with these three variations of your half splits. Slowly lift up, come back to center, and switch sides. Take your hands to the pinky edge of your left foot. This is usually the more challenging one, so if only one hand can get over, maybe the other hand rests on your shin bone or you use a block, you can do that. Back to center, bend your front knee. Toe heel your left foot out to set up for a dragon lunge. Again, keep your left knee stacked on top of your left ankle. Parallel your shin bone to the back of your mat and send your hips back and down as you fold forward. Tone your left butt cheek more to create more intensity in your stretch. Slowly come back to center. Extend your right toes back. Again, if you want to block under your hand or you want your strap or your towel, go for it. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, quad stretch or King Arthur stretch. Grab the pinky edge of your right foot this time. Spin your chest open. Pull your left shoulder head back as you kick your foot into your hand, hand back into your foot. Really nice work, guys. Slowly unravel. Toe heel your left foot back to the center of your space. Tuck your right toes. Inhale, crescent moon. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, triangle. Pause here. Inhale, sweep your top arm up and over. Exhale, wide-legged forward fold. Parallel your feet. Find your variation. If you'd like to add in maybe some skandasana, some side-to-side lunges, you can do that. If you'd like to twist, you can twist. Just find something that feels good to you, just for four. Let me fly into the moonlight. Three. Two. Land in your wide-legged forward fold in one. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, crawl forward, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop or step, top of your mat, have a seat. Grab a sip of water, wipe off your sweat, and then head right into your core work. Roll all the way onto your back. Extend your legs up to the sky. Either point through your toes or press the ball mounds of your feet. Right leg up, left leg down. Tuck your chin to your chest. Walk your hands up the back of your right leg. Breathe in. Exhale, exhale, pull it in. Switch sides. Exhale, exhale. Eight, seven, six, five. Hands can always be behind your head. Four, three. It's a straight leg bicycle in two, and one. Hands behind your head. Twist and twist. Twist and twist. If you want to have your knees bent here to take any pressure off your low back, you can. If you want to extend your arm across your leg, you can. Press your elbow, your hand, or your arm to the outside of the opposite thigh, not just to the thigh, but the outside. Keep your shoulder blade lifted, legs active, tone through your leg line, and brace your belly. Just 8, 7, 6, 5, boat pose in 4, 3, boat pose in 2, and 1, heels down, chest up. You can have your hands behind your legs. Lean your torso back, pull your shoulder blades together. Lift one foot, then the other. Extend your arms perhaps. Inhale, low boat. Exhale, boat pose. Keep going here. You always can have your hands by your side supporting you. You can have your hands behind your legs supporting you. Keep your shoulder blades off the ground, heels off the ground best you can. It's 4, 3, chaturanga in 2, and 1. Come up, cross your ankles, plant your palms, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, send your right leg high. Exhale, step your foot between your hands. Inhale, pyramid pose. Shorten your stance and pull your right hip back as you draw your left hip forward. Straighten your right leg. Both heels on the ground. You can have a block or blocks underneath your hands to bring the earth closer to you. And really, that's most important for keeping your hips square. A lot of the times you want to press your right hip out. It takes the stretch away a little bit, makes it not easier, but a little more comfortable. So you really want to stretch the meaty part of your hamstring. So really even out your hips from left to right. With every breath in, create length and space. Exhale, fold forward. If you shorten your stance, slowly lengthen it. Low lunge. Left hand down, right arm up, low lunge twist. You can still have a block under your head if you want here. Left hip up, right hip back, breathe in. Exhale, horizon lunge. Pivot to the pinky edges of both of your feet. Flex your feet. Keep your ankle bones off the ground by flexing or dorsiflexing your feet. Send your right arm high. You can stay high here. You can lower down. You can lift up. You can have arm circles, whatever you want here. Big breath in. Hold on your breath out. Slowly transition back to your lunge. Hop your back foot in again. Inhale, warrior one. Right hip back, left hip forward. Stack your right knee on top of your right ankle. Reach your arms to the sky, thumb bones back. Press down through your left heel. Interlace your hands behind your back. Inhale, puff up your chest. Exhale, humble warrior. Hinge at your hips and fold. You can use a towel or a strap here if it's a little tougher to touch your hands together, but the closer your palms are, the more intensity you'll feel here. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, chaturanga, plant your hands. Step your right foot back and lower down. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, send your left leg high. Exhale, step your foot between your hands, shorten your stance to set up for your warrior one, or rather your pyramid pose, excuse me. Pull your left hip back and your right hip forward. Use a block underneath your hands to bring the earth closer to you. Pull your left hip back and your right hip forward. Breathe in to create space and length. Exhale to fold deeper. Again, your left hip will want to bump out to the side. Continue to drive it back so both of your sitting bones point directly back, both of your hip bones point directly forward and down. Tone your thigh more, flex your thigh more to create more length in your hamstring. Slowly lengthen your stance again. Come into a low lunge. Right hand down, left arm up, low lunge twist. You can have a block under your right hand if you like it. Left hip back, right hip forward. Keep your right hip elevated, breathe in. Exhale, horizon lunge. Pivot to the pinky edges of your feet. All your toes point to the left edge of your mat. Flex your feet to keep your ankle bones off the ground. You can stay lifted here. You can lower down. You can add hip circles, arm circles. Breathe in. Hold on your breath out. Transition back to centaur, set up for warrior one. Back heel in, just like a pyramid pose, but stand all the way up this time. Stack your shoulders on top of your hips, left knee on top of your left ankle, reach your arms to the sky. Thumb bones back, arm bones in. Similar to your pyramid pose, point both of your hips forward. Drive through your back heel. Interlace your hands behind you, puff up your chest, inhale. Exhale, humble warrior. Press your palms together. Pull your left hip back. Your shoulder might bump into your left knee. That's okay. And again, the closer your palms are, the more intensity you feel. Inhale, work back up to your warrior one. Exhale, chaturanga. You can always replace it with a high plank. Up dog on your breath in. Downward facing dog on your breath out. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop or step, top of your mat, feet touch. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair pose, sit down and sweep your arms up, thumb bones back. Pull your rib cage in. If you look down at your toes, they should be visible. If not, sit your hips further back and down. Inhale. Exhale, airplane your arms behind you. Press weight into your heels and still connect all 10 toes to the earth. Inhale, one-legged Urdhva Hastasana. Stand up through your right leg. Lift your left leg and reach your arms to the sky. Pull your thigh bone up. Flex your left foot. Inhale. Exhale, dancer's pose. Bend your left knee so it draws back and up. Take your hand, thumb bone back. Keep your thumb bone back opened up and grab for the inside of your ankle. Align your middle finger to your ankle crease. This will allow for a deeper back bend to begin with. Squeeze your inner thighs, breathe in. Exhale, dancer's pose. Continue to hold here. Kick your foot into your hand, hand back into your foot. Tighten through your left glute. The more you tighten it, the more the front of your hip expands, the bigger you lift. You can start to tilt forward a little more, kick your leg a little higher, hold it here, then slowly release, Tadasana arms by your sides. Inhale, chair pose, sit down and sweep your arms up. Squeeze your inner thighs here, and actually squeeze your inner thighs and your inner calves together, but energetically rip your ankle bones apart, sit further back and down. Inhale. Exhale, airplane arms, pull your shoulder blades together, chest slightly forward, sit further back into your hips, connect all 10 toes to the earth. Inhale, one-legged Urdhva, reach your right thigh bone up, arms up, thumb bones back. Lift your thigh bone higher, tone through your arms, breathe in. Exhale, dancer's pose. Now, take your right arm, right elbow to your right side body. Hand is open, thumb bone is back, so palms open to the outside of your space. Grab hold of the inside of your right foot, middle finger to ankle crease. Squeeze your inner thighs, breathe in. Exhale, kick, dancer's pose. Hold it here. Again, kick your foot into your hand as you really activate through your hand to pull it back to you. The more you tighten up through your glutes, the more extension you'll feel in your hips. Lift your navel off the waistline of your pants. Gaze forward as you tilt forward and down as you kick your foot up higher. Hold it here. And relax and release Tadasana arms by your sides. Inhale, sweep your arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, chaturanga. Remember, you always can skip it. Down dog is your meeting place. Hold it here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, reach your right leg high. Exhale, step your foot between your hands. Inhale, crescent lunge. Stack your shoulders on top of your hips. If you have any tension in your low back, bend your knee a little bit. Otherwise, keep your legs straight. Breathe in. Exhale, warrior two. Stack right knee on top of right ankle. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Inhale, star pose, heels in, toes out. Exhale, horse pose, take your hands to your heart center. Hold it here. You can find little bounces. You can move your arms up and down. You can even take your hands to your inner thighs and twist. Just for four, wherever you are. Three. You meet in star pose in two. And one, star pose. Parallel your feet back to your wide-legged forward fold. See if you can go a little deeper than you did before. Breathe in, breathe out. Slowly come up, crawl yourself forward, land in a half pigeon. Toe heel your right foot towards the left edge of your mat, right knee towards your right wrist. Sit down on the front of your left thigh, knee, shin, and top of your foot. You can stay elevated or you can fold forward. Use a block underneath your forehead, your chest, your arms, to bring the earth closer. If you notice you're sitting on your outer right hip, you can put that block underneath your right butt cheek to bring the earth closer to you. Hold it here. Breathe in, breathe out. Slowly come back to your hands. Tuck your left toes, three-legged dog. You can open your hip, bend your knee, maybe flip your dog if it's in your practice. Meeting place is down dog. Inhale, send your left leg high. Exhale, step your foot between your hands, low lunge. Inhale, crescent lunge, shoulders on top of your hips. Activate your legs and your core. Exhale, warrior two. Squeeze your inner thighs, armpits down. Inhale, star pose, heels in, toes out. Exhale, into your horse pose. Sit down. Good. Again, here you can twist, you can bounce, you can bend and straighten. If you want to hold a deeper variation, you can come into spider pose with your forearms on the insides of your thighs. Hold it here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Just for three. Meet in a star pose in two. And one, meeting your star pose, heels in, toes out. Parallel your feet, go back into your wide-legged forward fold again. If you have a tripod headstand here you want to do on your own, you're welcome to do that, or any other sort of bind or variation arm balance that you can get to from here is welcome. Otherwise, stay in your fold. Breathe in. Breathe out. Make your way back to your fold. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, crawl forward to a lunge. Toe heel your left foot to the right edge of your mat. Left knee towards your left wrist. Lower down into your pigeon pose. Work to align your knee more towards your left wrist. It's okay if your shin bone is closer to you, if it's closer parallel, those are both right. And again, use your blocks to bring the earth closer to you. You can bring your block underneath your left butt cheek to bring the earth closer to you. Hold it here. In this active recovery, come back to your intention. How have your thoughts and mind been during the practice? Are you stuck back in your old ways of thinking or feeling about the poses, the postures, the breaths? And for this last bit of practice, you come with that light heart, the mind of a not-knower, the mind of a person who's willing to see things in a different way. slowly come back to your palms. Tuck your toes, sweep your left leg high, big breath in. Exhale, open your hip, bend your knee. If you have a flip dog in your practice, you're welcome to go there. Meeting place is downward facing dog. All right, time to practice our sort of peak posture of class. It'll be splits. So I only have one block with me, but if you've got two blocks, that's very helpful, just depending on where you are in your practice. From here, so there's two ways you can really get into it, two ways I really like to teach it. Depending on how strong you are through, or rather how supple you are through your hamstrings or your quads or hip flexors. So first option is you're gonna move into it from that half split we set up in our sun B earlier in class. So now this can be where your split is today. You're in your half split, you stay here, flex your foot, continue to dig down through your heel and pull your right hip back. Or if you've got a very open hamstring, start to wiggle your right foot forward, then draw your left knee back. You'll notice I'm leaning forward a little bit, so this is a great place to grab a block. If I had two, I'd have one under each hand. You can keep your left toes tucked or untucked. Continue to dig your heel down, point your right toes directly to the sky. Now, second option, this usually works a little better for me. I'll switch legs for it. I like to wiggle my left back leg back first, a little bit more opening to the front of my hips. So from here, I keep my left leg where it is, but I start to work my right leg back. This just gives me more space. Now from here, depending on where you are, you can still have that block underneath your hands. Or if you're getting really close to the earth but not quite there, you can put a block underneath the top edge of your hamstring closer to your glutes. You can keep your hands on either side of that block. You can let your hands go, let them rest. Continue to dig your left heel down, pull your left hip back, right hip forward. Now, if you are all the way on the earth, you're sitting directly on the earth with your pelvis, you can reach your arms to the sky. You can hinge forward and fold. You can also reach up and create a back bend sensation. Wherever you are, hold it here. If you haven't switched sides, be sure to switch sides. You'll have a few more moments here. Remember to dig your front heel down, flex or dorsiflex your front foot back. And the more you can center your weight, shoulders on top of hips, the more you'll get closer to that full split sensation or feeling. Hips still square forward, so hip bones point forward. Good, if you want more time to play, pause the video. Otherwise, head into a quick child's pose. You can allow your forehead to rock side to side. Start to massage that center marma point, that pressure point. And inhale, pull yourself to a tabletop. Sit on one of your hips. Extend your legs forward. Take your block down with you as you lower. You might want it, you might not. But lower all the way down onto your mat. Bring the soles of your feet to the earth. Hands down by your sides. Inhale, bridge pose. Press through your palms, drive through your heels as you lift your hips. Slightly tuck your chin to your chest. You can stay here. You can walk your shoulder blades underneath you to create a pillow for the back of your heart. Or if you want a supported bridge, take your block, place it underneath you, and allow the back of your hips to rest on your block. If you do take this variation, you're also welcome to extend your legs forward for an extended supported bridge. My friends in bridge pose, hold it here, breathe in. Lower down, breathe out. You do that one more time. If you have no pose in your practice, you're welcome to go there. I'm not gonna do a big demo of that today, but bridge or wheel, inhale one more time and lift up. My friends in the supported bridge, if you haven't extended your legs yet, feel free to do so. Everybody breathe in. Lift your hips higher, including those resting on your blocks. On your exhale, lower yourself all the way down to your yoga mat. Remove your block. Pause. Knock your knees together. Gently hug your knees to your chest. Bring your nose up between your knees. Rock forward and back, side to side. Draw your knees all the way over to the left. Take your arms into a T or goalpost arms, gaze over to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale, switch sides. Inhale back to center. Tuck your knees to your chest. You can give yourself one of those big squeezes with your nose between your knees again. And if there's any final postures you need to tie up your practice with a nice little bow, do that. You can pause the video here. Otherwise, head into Shavasana. Extend your legs forward. Reach your arms above your head for a final full body stretch, and then exhale. Really fall into your Shavasana, arms by your sides. Walk your shoulder blades underneath you to create a pillow for the back of your heart. And rest. Take a big breath in. Sigh it out. Rest here. Allow yourself to fully let go of whatever preconceived notions you have about yourself, others, or what's going on in the world around you. And with every breath in, can you take in a new idea, a new feeling, a new ability to explore? Knowing that as you let go of preconceptions and you open up to exploration, you can shift the way you move through the world. You can shift the way your life unfolds. You have that power. Use it. It was my pleasure guiding you today and practicing along with you. Have a lovely rest of your day. Namaste.